Hello and welcome to the Computer Labs YouTube channel. So today we are looking at a powerful inbuilt tool called InPainting for removing unwanted items out of photographs. In this video I'll be showing you how to use the InPainting brush tool that's built into Affinity Photo, and also how to use the freehand selection tool. Both of these allow you to remove items from photographs really quickly and easily. Okay, to start off, we will use the brush tool, the InPainting brush tool that's built into Affinity Photo. So first thing obviously we need to do is open Affinity Photo up. I'll just click on my icon there and we'll get Affinity Photo opened up. Okay, so I'm just starting off with the startup panel. And now I have got a couple of images already just saved just to keep this video nice and quick. So I've got them left on my desktop. And I'm going to start off, like I say, using the InPainting brush tool. So I'm just going to drag this picture of this, I think it's a picture of some flags. Yeah, so it's a picture of some stone, some rock, and it's got the a peg that's just sat on the picture here. So the aim is to quickly just remove this item out of the photograph. So it always works better, these tools, when it has a lot of the background you're trying to keep in the frame of the picture. So you can see on this picture, there's lots of color with the flags it can work off. So we'll just look at trying to remove the peg and just see what it looks like once it's got rid of it. Okay, so on the left hand side, you should have your toolbar menu, as you can see here. And about 3/4 of the way down is the one that we want. And if we just click on the little icon here, you can see we are presented with another submenu. And the one that we want, if yours are not already showing, is the InPainting brush tool. So once you select that, you'll be then presented with a circle. And depending on how big your item is on the picture or how small it is, you can change the width of the circle. So you can see here I'm currently at 75 points. If I make it bigger, then obviously it changes the size of the circle. And again, if you go down to like down to 1 pixel, you can work very minuscule sort of detail within the picture. But I'll leave around 75 because Affinity Photo likes it's really powerful, this tool, and as long as it's got a bit of background to work off, it will work really well. Well, set mine at 75%. Again, make sure you've got the tool selected, as I have here, the InPainting brush tool, make sure you're still on that. And if you left click on the mouse and drag around the item on the photograph, you will see a red box. Don't let go of it at this point. You can just click and let go, which I'll show you in a second. But if I left click, drag, and you see it shows a red sort of marker overlay around the item that we are trying to remove. So I'll just highlight all the peg, as you can see, as I'm just going around it. And once you've got the item selected, let go. Affinity Photo, depending on how powerful your machine is, just does the magic, and then, as you can see, disappears straight away. Really nice, really powerful tool, really quick and easy way to get something out of a photograph, remove people, say on a beach or something like that. Like I said, as long as it's got a lot of foreground to work from, really quick, easy, powerful. And then you can zoom in, so you can see there's, now you might want to keep that photograph where it is, but I'll just zoom in on the photograph and you can see these sort of white chalk marks in the picture. I could left click and just drag on these and just watch them disappear, but I can also just left click and just one click. So if I just try and pick that one, for example, and I'll just make it a touch bigger. Let's just see what it looks like. If I make my width of my circle a bit bigger, so I just click on it once, and you'll see it just disappears. So I'm not left clicking, dragging, I'm just clicking on the items I want to remove. So as I go around the picture, I'm just left clicking once on the item I want to remove. And again, I might want to try and remove these down here. And it's all just using this same tool, this InPainting brush tool. If I left click and drag, and you can see it just removes all these items out of the picture as you go along. Okay, so I'll zoom back out. You see, so it's starting to look nice and tidy. Really quick, easy, powerful tool. A really nice way to tidy photographs up. Okay, so the next tool I'm going to show you how to use is it's the same type of technology that it uses to remove items out of a photograph. But this one's using the either a freehand selection tool, or you can use the marquee tool, or basically the shape tool to highlight a certain area that you're trying to remove. So I'll just close this window down, don't want to save that for now. And we'll drag this picture here in. Okay, so this is purely, I took this purely just so I could show you exactly how it works. So you can see the sky, the foreground here, and this left-hand section where the tree is just interfering with my skyline, and I want to remove that. Now I could use the same tool, which I've just shown you there, but the best one to really use when you're selecting around a certain item is do it sort of freehand. So in the tools panel again, we need to find the freehand selection tool. So if you go across to the left-hand menu, left-click, it's about a quarter way down, and you see they have the different shapes, which I will show you in a second, but the one that we want is the one that looks like a lasso, freehand selection tool. So again, select this, make sure it's highlighted that we know we have it selected, and now we just left-click on the mouse and dragging around the item, and just making sure you get all around it. And like I say, all I'm doing is just dragging around the item that I want to cut out. So there it's selected the item that I've highlighted, and you've got the marching ants going round the bit that you've selected. Make sure that you've got obviously the one and nothing that should be in there is not removing. So again, like I said, this is the same tool that we're using before. And now we need to go up to the edit menu on the top toolbar, click on edit, and then as we go down, you'll notice the one that says InPaint. Click on InPaint. Let Affinity Photo do its magic, and we should see the tree removed. And that's it, and you can see it's filled the sky in, but again, a really powerful tool, really good way of removing stuff out of photographs, stuff, unwanted items. And I'll just undo that, I'll just bring that back in again. And what I will do, I'll just show you the other way that you can do it. So if you've got, say something in the middle of a photograph, a bird or something in the frame, you can use different tools. So again, about a quarter way down, click on the selection tool and you can pick one of these up. So say for example, I wanted to use the rectangular marquee tool, and you can use that to draw a shape around the item we want to remove. So it's easy on this because there's nothing else interfering with my photograph. So for example, if there was a tree cutting in here, I'd have to use a freehand. But all I'm telling the Affinity Photo is I want to infill this section. So really good if you're doing sort of a circular shape around a bird or something like that, but we'll leave it as that one, the rectangle one. Again, up to the edit menu, down to InPaint, click on InPaint, let Affinity Photo do its magic, do its thing, let it remove it out of the photograph. And again, depending on how powerful your machine is, will take depending on how long it will take. But as you can see, removes it from the photograph, and then we're left with a nice clean image that we can then manipulate as we want. Okay, so that's how to use the InPainting tools built into Affinity Photo. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please do give us a thumbs up. Please do subscribe to my channel. And please don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this. And thank you very much for watching the Computer Labs YouTube channel.